With major parts of the Philippines still under enhanced community quarantine, the outlook for the once fast-growing economy becomes dimmer by the day. Former Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Shalito Habito admits he's ruling out a V-shaped economic recovery for the Philippines even after the pandemic is done. This means he's not seeing a quick jumpstart to economic activity post-COVID-19. Instead, Habito says the country may experience a protracted U-shaped recovery wherein growth will stay low or even turn negative for an extended period.
The ones that actually contribute the most in terms of GDP, in terms of jobs, are the ones that are at least lend themselves to social distancing, like, again, the wholesale and retail trade and so on.
This includes malls and other micro, small, and medium enterprises, which comprise 90% of all businesses in the Philippines. For now, Habito asserts the Philippines should further boost its testing capacity for COVID-19 in order to have a clearer picture on the pandemic's grip on the country.
We all know that the numbers we're getting are more a function of how fast we're able to test rather than, you know, how fast or how slowly the pandemic is spreading. So that is the number one piece of information we need to be able to plan our next steps ahead.
Habito, who had his fair share of crises during his time as socioeconomic planning chief, also says government can consider reopening crucial parts of the economy once the extended enhanced community quarantine lapses on April 30.
We can resume the infrastructure projects, and I think Secretary Pernia had been, in fact, batting for this. No? Because at least in construction sites, people don't have to be crowded together, I think. You know? So especially if there's a lot of mechanization. Some manufacturing can resume, for example, those that are in assembly lines where people don't have to be so close to one another.
He also expressed confidence newly appointed Acting Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua can help lead the country's economic recovery post-COVID-19.
He is much more than a tax expert. He is actually a well-rounded economist. At the World Bank and even at the Ateneo Economics Department, you know, he was very much concerned about poverty and social development. And so he precisely exemplifies what you need at the leadership of MEDA. Just like Secretary Ernie Pernia, whose professional focus really through most of his economic career was in human development.
Chua replaced Ernesto Pernia this week after he surprisingly announced his resignation last April 17, citing personal reasons and differences with some of his fellow cabinet members. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News,